I'm either making gains or getting fat.
One shot, everything rides on two. Night, even if I got three strikes, I'ma go for it. This moment, we own it.
What is going on, rich homies? Thank you for clicking on the video. I want to talk about something very quickly that's so simple, and that is treating people better. Now, I'm not talking about this because I'm a great person and everyone needs to treat people like I treat people. It's definitely not like that, but I've noticed something very interesting, and that's that people want to talk about money. People want to talk about finances, but not a lot of people talk about human capital, and there's so many similarities. So think about going to the bank, right? Whether it be Chase Bank, Fifth Third, whoever you bank with. In order to take out money, you have to deposit money. So you have to put something in to take something out. Now, the way that I look at things is every person that you meet or every person that you have a relationship with, you have a bank with that person. You have to invest something into that person to get anything out. And that probably sounds a little bit selfish, which I do think that humans are inherently selfish. But even if it's like your husband or your wife, you know, you have to invest love into them to get love out. You can't just expect them to keep giving and giving. And really, when you think about any context, right, maybe you're at work and you're going to need a favor from almost every person that you work with at some time, I can guarantee it. And the only way they're going to want to help you is if you've invested something in them, whether that be time or just common courtesy. Now, obviously, we should just treat people well because there should not have to be any reason. There should be no reason that you purposely treat someone bad. And just because I am a little bit older than the people watching these videos usually, I've been in the working world for a bit now, one thing that I have learned is you should be treating the secretary the exact same as you treat the executive. I'm telling you, the likability factor, regardless of what you're doing in life, is huge. I'm not even kidding with you guys. I absolutely love this Power Cereal Puff Wheat, and then a half scoop of the PES Select Cafe. This stuff is delicious. And I always like to give you guys practical examples, and I hate to always relate it back to YouTube, but that's what I do on here, right? So I guess an example for me would be, I invest in each and every one of you. So I try to help you out the best I can. I try to provide you guys with the best content, the best information possible. I try to answer all of your questions because I want something from you. I want your time. I want you to come in and watch these videos. I want you to use Travis to save 30% at PEScience.com if you're gonna buy these products. It's little examples like that.
I'm not to be played with because it can get dangerous. See, these people I ride with, this moment we own it.
Now I just feel like I'm gonna win. Hold me west side, that's my kin. Beneath the beautiful, that's my pen. You trying to get dope, but I just am. I was born with it, did a tour with it. Them overseas girls always give you more digits. I've been blessed, I done went shore to shore with it.
Actually, really been enjoying cream of rice lately, and the one thing I warn you guys about, if you want to try it, is you have to mix something in it. If you taste it by itself, it's pretty bad. So mix something sweet in there. I think you guys will like it.
Got some facts on the wall, and I'm still dope. I'm just trying to show the people that it's still hope. You buy an album and we stir up a meal, bro. The label's like, that's gonna cost you a meal, bro. So bad. God told me to.
That transition would have been so much better if this video was sponsored by Movement. Unfortunately, it is not. We used to work together back in the day, if you guys remember. I think they've kind of moved on to bigger and better YouTubers, which is fine, but it just goes to show, I'm not just trying to sell out on you guys. I don't show you products I think are crap. I'm still wearing this watch, even though they don't even pay me anymore.
I'm not to be played with because it can get dangerous.
Yeah, Millie.
I always try to get pretty stimmed out if I know I'm going to be around a large group of people. It's just something that helps me kind of communicate a little bit better, helps me find words in my brain.
I own it.
I bought it. I own it. You borrow. I loan it. I got people rocking clothes with my
I get a lot of questions from people asking what they should do when they go out as far as tracking goes, whether that be from food or from drinking. And I really don't have a good way to say how not serious that it is. You shouldn't be tracking unless you're driving. Then you should probably be tracking your drinks, because drinking and driving is idiotic.
Cause I keep working, I keep grinding, I keep writing, I keep
should always.
No one gave that advice because
one good lot different than what's on the nutrition labels. Always use them, but every once in a while it's a good idea.
Healthier lifestyle. My recommendation to you as far as
I love this poverty brownie. I don't know if I'm the only one that does this, but a lot of times I'll just end the night with a sleeve of rice cakes. Fills me up, tastes pretty good. See you guys tomorrow.
It's Kroger brand.
Jeffrey loves Kroger. Travis ass.
Travis S. loves
You're
Kroger.
Watching this. What up, Trav?
Like, some people value virtual currency, some people value price. People, a lot of people like coupons. Executing an instant. Like, how is that smart?
Right. Yeah, but I think,
You learn a lot about yourself on YouTube, and one of the things that I've learned is apparently I wear the same clothes a lot because I get comments on that from time to time. Not like every day, but every now and again I'll get these comments like, Travis, why don't you go buy new clothes? Well, I was getting insecure about that. So I got some new clothes. Are you guys excited? These are some designer Levi jeans. Calvin Klein work shirt. Pretty nice if I did say so myself. And then a few Public Opinion shirts, which is just Nordstrom's brand. And if you go to Nordstrom Rack, which hopefully you guys have one around you, these are always like 2 for $30. So I will add these to the rotation and make you guys happy. So I've got this really bad habit about buying things and then not fitting, especially jeans. Jeans never fit. But then I never want to take them back to the store, so I end up giving them away to Goodwill or something. Hopefully these just fit. Jeez Louise, dude. These don't even fit now, and I don't even lift anymore. Now, I really do like to have nice things. I like my clothes to look nice. I'd love to go out and buy a new car. But to me, spending is much different than investing. And I really like to see a return if I'm going to be spending a whole lot of money. I guess the typical accountant, right? I get a lot of questions on like college, for example. You can see up here, I mean, this stuff is obviously not very cheap. Two master's degrees, $20,000 per. So you're looking at $40,000 for two pieces of paper, not even including undergrad, which is probably, I don't know, probably another 20 grand. So you're talking about 60 grand. So what kind of return did that have, right? A lot of times I think people are asking questions that no one really knows the answer to, especially when it comes down to the college conversation. Like, I don't know, was getting master's degrees worth it? Maybe not. I mean, but the thing is, even though I might not be getting paid for it in terms of monetary value right now, I learned a lot of lessons. I met a lot of people. There's a lot of things that can happen down the line from it. So there's a lot of things, in my opinion, that you just can't quantify. And it drives people like me crazy. I mean, I want to put a number to every single thing. What I can tell you is that the best investment that I have personally ever made is in people. First being myself. Because like I've mentioned before, I honestly think that you have to invest in yourself before you're able to invest in other people. But outside of that, just investing, whether that be time or resources, into developing people or establishing relationships, things like that. And I think what people will find is if you do these types of things, then the money will always come. But what I can tell you is, in terms of the biggest investment that I've ever made, it's not this house that I'm standing in right now. It's this guy. You're looking at him. And since we talked about like banks and finances a little bit earlier, even right now, I want to introduce you guys to one more bank that I oftentimes reference.
This moment,
we own it.
This is what I call the Bank of F's, and it's really built around a premise off of something that I believe, and that is, you can only genuinely care about a very limited number of things that you face throughout the day. And you can probably guess where I'm going with this and why I use the letter F, but it could be any letter that you like. But I think that maybe you have like a capacity, whether that be energy, time, or just overall sanity, to deal with like 4 or 5 things that you genuinely care about. No lie, a few months ago, I was looking for magnetic Fs online to actually do this demonstration, but somebody really dropped the ball. You're supposed to be finding those for me. You know who you are. So here's how I look at it. So you start every day with like 4 Fs, right? But the issue that I see most people run into is how easily they give these up. So for example, they start the morning, they're driving to work, and oh my gosh, someone just cut them off and they're just livid, right? They're going nuts, they're driving, flying by and flipping them off, and by the time they get to work, they're just distraught. They're going from cube to cube and telling everybody about this person. Well, guess what? You just lost an F. Oh, you heard Sally was talking about you, didn't you? She didn't like what you were wearing. You're gonna have to post a mean subtweet about her, but guess what? When you do that, see ya. Some guy on YouTube had a clickbait title. God, I'm a little bit passionate about that one. What? Here is the problem, my friends. It seems like 90% of the people that I run into, they waste all of these Fs before it gets to be like 10 o'clock. So later on in the day, they have a RP, a real problem, and they have no more capacity to actually care about things that actually matter. There is my strategy to happiness. Simplify your life. I promise you, you will reap the benefits from it.
So I think the one thing, and it was funny, was that awkward pause that we all just took.
All packed up, heading out to Florida, which is gonna be awesome. It's like 70 degrees there right now. Time for some spring break action. I wish that I had video from spring break back in college. Good Lord. But I'll be out there for work for a few days. So just a short trip. It'll be nice though. Get away for a little bit. Gotta hit the gym though. There has got to be a better way to do this. I cannot just sit here and hold this on myself all day, but I try to keep it as honest with you guys as possible. I mean, one of the things I really pride myself in is just keeping it real, you know? I'm in a good position because I can do and say certain things that other people cannot, because this is not my occupation, this is not my full-time job, I do not depend on it. I just do it for fun, and I try to be as forthcoming and honest with you guys as I possibly can. And I truly love PES products. I know you guys get sick of me saying it, and I'm always throwing in the discount code and all that, but not just for me, but for everybody. You should always be a little bit, I guess, hesitant when someone that's sponsored is talking about a product, because we're biased. I mean, that I'm not denying that at all. But I have to tell you guys, Prolific is an awesome pre-workout. I did not think that it was going to make me give up high volume and Alphamine, which it hasn't, because I still go back and forth, but this stuff, I shouldn't tell you this. Okay, I mixed Prolific and Alphamine one day, and honestly, I just felt like I could fly. Do not do that unless, I don't know. I do 2 scoops of Prolific. That ends up being a little bit over 300 milligrams of caffeine. Typically, I'll just drink this while I'm walking on the treadmill when I have more time like this on the weekends. Walk for like 20 minutes by that time. It gets in my system. I listen to some ignorant rap music. That's like my favorite combination in life.
Take care of yourself, okay?
Yeah.
Heal up.
Soon.
Heal up. We will. Heal up, bro. All
right, man.
The only thing more awkward about doing these in public is recording yourself doing them. And that is how we're gonna end the video. Thank you guys so much for taking the time out of your day to watch. You could have been doing anything, and you chose to spend a few minutes with me. Like the video if you want to see EC more on this channel. It'd be pretty cool to get him on here. Or just like the video for the clickbait, the bad jokes, or any other content that you may or may not have liked, just for me. I'd appreciate it. I look forward to talking to you guys next time.